Now let's move on to overloading operators. Here at the top, I've defined a struct called team record that records the number of wins and losses for a team. We'll just assume this struct is describing the wins and losses for a team playing American football, that's in season right now. Now it would be convenient if we could add two team records together like we would any other basic type. And that's what I'm trying to do here. But unless we write a function that describes how two team records could be added together, the Swift compiler won't be able to perform this operation. So, to define addition, we'll start with func and then the plus symbol. Then, addition takes two arguments, an argument that goes on the left side of the addition sign and an argument that goes on the right side. Both of the arguments should be team records, and we want to return a new team record after performing what we'd describe as the addition of two team records. So for team records, we just want to add the numbers of wins together and the number of losses together. We can do this in one line by returning a new instance of team record and adding the wins and losses from the left and right side in line right here. And now our addition works just like a charm. It takes the records for 2013 and 2014, it adds the wins together, and it adds the losses together, and you can see that outputted here. Now you may be asking yourself, if I had to define the addition for team records, does that mean addition is defined for ints, strings, floats, and other basic types too? Well, that's a great question, and you're right, they are. So when you think about it, when we defined addition here for team records, we were actually overloading the addition operator to work with a new type, in this case, team records. So we could, in fact, redefine how addition works for any type, like the basic type ints. So I'll go ahead and do that now for demonstration purposes, but this would be a terrible idea in real code. So you can see now that the addition of two ints gives us some really strange results. And again, this is a really, really bad idea. Do not do this in practice. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this for now, just so I don't have someone yell at me later.